Alright, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Let's Play Terraria. We're starting off on the title screen here, because I haven't done this for a little while, and because I was actually doing some stuff off-screen. I've been working on various things for like a week or two, just working on, like, you know, finding or completing my platform to look for the Sky Islands, and then I was working on doing some expansion on some of my tunnels and all sorts of other stuff. Plus, spring happens to be, you know, starting right now, so I've been outside doing crap in the yard and whatnot. So anyways, we're going to hop on in here, and I was doing something off-screen just a couple hours ago, guys. And the Goblin Army decided to spawn. And I was like, oh, well, great, now I get to deal with these guys. And then I thought, wait a minute. I think they just stay there as long as you don't kill them. So, like, the only way they go away is if you actually kill them. And I was like, well, I haven't actually shown this on screen yet, have I? So, hopefully, I'm not proven a fool here. Hopefully, the Goblin Army is in fact here. Yep, the Goblin Army is in fact here. Okay. So, yeah, this is the Goblin Army. It's just kind of a moderate pain in the ass. You'll also see that there are some changes to the general area around my base. I'll go over those once I have dealt with the Goblin Army. So the Goblin Army basically consists of several of these different types of goblins. There are Goblin Warriors, Goblin Thieves, there was also a Goblin Peon, I believe. There's this really annoying Goblin Sorcerer. And, what was the last one? Oh, the Goblin Archers, right. Can I get up there, please? Thank you. And, basically, this boils down to just kill everything that's trying to kill you. For the most part, none of these enemies are really all that threatening. I would say the most threatening enemy is probably the Goblin Archers. And that's just because if you get a bunch of them all, like, in one area, and they keep constantly knocking you back with their attacks, it can make it really, really annoying to deal with them. But other than that, they're all relatively easy. So the main threat here that the Goblin Army poses... Oh, and right, I should probably throw away something so that I can get these. As you can see, I was doing stuff in the world underground. I was doing some mining and whatnot. So yeah, my inventory is completely full. What do I want to get rid of? I guess I can get rid of these active stone blocks, right? I don't imagine I'm ever really gonna use them, so get rid of those so I can pick up these spiky balls, because they are actually worth some money. Or rather, they're not necessarily worth money, but they're worth something to me. Is that a gun? Hold on. I guess I don't really need that one either that badly. Oh, that's a harpoon. Okay. Interesting. Does that harpoon actually do anything for me? 26 range damage. Interesting. Do I need, like, an actual, like, ammo type for that? Okay. I mean, it's effective at what it does, but I feel like this weapon is probably more effective the closer you are to your enemy, so calling it a ranged weapon is kind of meh in my opinion. I wouldn't really call this a ranged weapon. This is a weapon that can have range, but it is really best used as a melee weapon, really. So, yeah, it's okay, but it's not going to be my weapon of choice, that's for damn sure. So, probably the most annoying thing about this is just that there's a crap load of enemies to give a fight. It takes forever because the enemies just, like, they're constantly here. Like, as the name of the Goblin Army implies, you have to fight a freaking army. There's an army of enemies to defeat, and it takes a little while. So I'm gonna be here for a little while. You may have noticed, I guess I can talk about these fences here. So, I was wondering about fences. I think I saw them somewhere. Some guy used them for something or other. Or just put them up because he liked the way that they looked around his base or whatever. And I was like, okay, well, let me take a look at all the fence types. So this one right here, behind me currently, is a completely normal fence that's just made out of normal wood. The fence right here is actually shade wood. This is a shade wood fence made out of shade wood, which you find in the, God damn it. Okay, these sorcerers are really bugging me, so I have to. I have to kill them. Aw, they broke down my doors again. God damn it, I have to put those up again after I'm done here. But I think you get those from the corruption, and I think you can get a very similar wood type called ebon wood in the actual corruption zone. I'm not sure if it actually looks the same, but it looks okay. And then to the left of that, this fence right here, which happens to be my favorite. This is a boreal fence made out of boreal wood, which is the wood that you find in the winter zones. This right here is rich mahogany, which of course you will find in the jungle biome. And then this right here is made out of palm wood, which you will find near the ocean. So those are the various types of fences that I have currently. I'm not... Get in here and just kill the stupid sorcerer. Thank you. So those are the various fences that I can make out of woods that are in my world. Maybe there's a type or two that I'm actually missing somewhere. I don't know where they would be, but, you know, they might be somewhere, I guess. But I just kind of wanted to... I wanted to place them all down. I wanted to do some tests with them. I wanted to see what they look like. And apparently you can put torches on these fences. So you can see down below me, this was meant to be my actual, like, surface area. Like, I just wanted to be this wide open area. And I ended up putting this minecart track on it because I was like, well, I need to get from one side of the world to the other kind of quickly. And it works out, but at the same time, it's like, well, this is no longer really my surface area, is it? It's not really a surface if I have a thing here. And I didn't really want these stupid dirt walls here either. Unfortunately, I'm in a bad place to keep killing goblins. So I need to deal with that. And actually, I'll go up to my battle platform. Maybe I can get some more goblins to spawn if I run up here. Or I can get the ones that spawn down in my tunnels to, like, move. So they won't be in a place where it's really annoying for me to fight them. There we go, this is a lot better. Of course I'm getting hit a bunch, but that's fine. It's not like they do that much damage. But yeah, I just... Oh, okay, the Goblin Army's been defeated. Sweet. So now I just gotta clean up the stragglers, and we will be done. But yeah, I don't really like the dirt walls. I don't want all that to be on my surface area, so... I was like, well, can I do something else? And as it turns out, yeah, the fences. I can go ahead and put up fences, and that way I will have a nice, convenient... place to put down lighting and whatnot, and yeah, that'll look a lot nicer than what I currently have. Okay, so was that the last of the goblins? Hopefully that was the last of them. Hopefully. I'm gonna go in here real quick, and I'm gonna go ahead and stow away a whole bunch of my stuff. So I will be right back, guys. Okay, so I went ahead and cleaned out my inventory. So anyways, about these fences, I've decided that I like the boreal fence the most. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys that I have placed a whole bunch of trees over here in the winter zone. And I will be farming those offline or off screen or whatever you want to call it. In order to get a whole bunch of that, and eventually this dirt wall that's below me or behind me here, it's just I'm gonna take it all down. I'm gonna take down this dirt ceiling, and I'm just gonna replace this entire background with boreal fences, and I will put the torches on the fences. That way I can still have lighting along the way. I'm also going to get rid of this minecart track. And you might be wondering, well, why are you doing that, Fox? Because you wanted to play a way to get around really easily. I did. However, I also want a place where I can plant trees and such. And if you look over here to the left, like, I may want shade wood for things and whatnot, but like right now the surface area, it just looks like another tunnel that I have down below, so I can't distinguish the difference between the surface and the tunnel right now. My surface area and my tunnels, and also, like, you know, if I wanted to grow like some palm wood for something, which I might want to do in this desert area. Right now, I can't do it, because, unfortunately, there is a whole bunch of, you know, dirt that's just blocking where the grows, or where the trees would be able to grow. Where the grows, yes. So, I kind of want to do that, and then if I want to get around quickly, I've made this minecart track up here that's a little higher in the air. It might still block some of the trees from growing to their full height and stop me from getting a lot of wood for every tree, but at the very least I can still do, you know, a decent amount. So again, I don't want to spend too much time looking at the map, but obviously you can see I have done some extensive work. I have found a couple of sky islands. I have made a wooden platform that runs all the way from one side of my world all the way to the other. I also selected a place for a lake in the jungle biome, and I made the lake. So now I have a jungle lake, a normal lake over here. I have technically a desert biome lake, and I have a winter biome lake, though that one actually needs a lot more water. Now I'm not entirely sure about these fishing mechanics. I need to start doing fishing quests, because I know that'll unlock a whole bunch of other things. And I'm not sure, I don't know, do you guys actually want to see me do the fishing quests? Because, like, all they are, as I understand it, is, you know, guy tells you, I found so-and-so fish in so-and-so area, why don't you go get one for me? And, you know, you go and you do it, and then you do the same thing again the next day. Well, he gives you a different quest, but, you know. So I don't know if you guys really want to see that. I don't know. But yeah, I made the platform from one side of the world to the other. Now, I don't know if there are any more sky islands way up in the air. Like, as you can see, clearly there's a good amount of area above here that I could still potentially explore. But I found 1, 2, 3 sky islands in my world thus far. And I made some wood platforms to head up there. So, yeah, I think I'm gonna start with the one on the left first. I think that's the smallest one. So, without too much further ado, Let's go ahead and head on over there, and I'm just gonna go to the left, grab that one, and then I'm just gonna hit all the ones to the right of that. But yeah, doing all of this, it took a little bit of work, certainly, it took a while. I ended up having to put a little tiny dirt background on the, on these wood platforms so that I can place down torches. That way I could actually see, because, oh my goodness, trying to do this in the dead of night. Oh, so many things. I would just keep running into, like, zombies and slimes. And when I was jumping up and down to actually reveal the map a little bit to see if there was a sky island there, every once in a while I'd run into a harpy and it would start coming down and shooting me. And it's like, well, I can't exactly dodge the harpy feathers in the pitch black darkness because I can't see where the hell they are. So I had to put up all these torches. That was kind of a pain. So yeah, today we're gonna be checking out these sky islands. Hopefully I'm almost there to the one on the far left. And then after I do the sky islands, I think what I'm gonna go ahead and do, guys, is I'm gonna show you a couple of chests that I found while I was working on my tunnels. And I might do a little bit of exploration in those tunnels as well. How much I do will kind of depend on, on various things. But as you can see, the higher up you get, the lower the gravity gets. So I should be able to jump up there from this platform. So let us see what this Sky Island has in store for us. They have a funky little door for me. Okay. And, what be in this chest? Okay! A legendary Star Fury! I have not actually come up to this area, by the way. This is my first time actually looking in this chest. I wasn't even sure there was a chest here. This is 26 melee damage, 30% crit strike, very fast speed, average knockback, causes stars to rain from the sky, Forged with the Fury of Heaven, and it has plus 14% damage, 10% speed, 5% crit strike, 10% size, and 15% knockback. I'll take that. Yes. So that's probably going to be my new main weapon, most likely. That's, as opposed to my Legendary Katana. My Legendary Katana is still really good. I mean, it's got some crazy crits, but the extra 7 melee damage, and then the effect of causing the stars to rain down from the sky. Yeah, it just, like, and those things can actually cause damage to enemies as well. Now, I think, does using the sword use up mana? If it does use up mana, it uses it up at a very, very slow rate. So I can very easily spam the ever-living shit out of that. Okay, so a gravity banner. Okay. We have a world banner, and I think this is another gravity banner, right? Yes. Okay, cool. Skyware chair. So we're going to go ahead and grab some of these. Okay, interesting. And grab the Skyware chest, because why the hell not? And I'm just going to disassemble this house. Because I can. Because these are materials that I'm not sure if I can actually make. But if I can, I have no idea how. But these are some pretty unique materials, so I would like to grab them. I think you can also mine the Sky Island and make, like, take the materials from the Sky Island and make your own, like, custom-built Sky Island. Which is a pretty cool concept. I might go ahead and grab a couple pieces, but I think I'm gonna leave the Sky Island where it is for the time being, just because I don't really have any, like, super amazing, plans for it.